Welcome back to the Rhode Show. This morning in the Buzz, Halloween is really just a fun time of year, and certainly not as expensive as Christmas or New Year's, but to some it is. But from the candy to the costumes, it still can burn a little hole in those wallets. In fact, it's the fourth most popular holiday that gets us spending. National Retail Federation expects nearly $7 billion to be spent on the festive tradition, but that's about $1 billion less than last year. So the average person is spending about 75 bucks on Halloween.
I can understand that.
Yes. It's new costumes. Because, if you got to go out and buy costumes.
Well, you think of the trick-or-treaters, like, okay, you got to get the
candy's
candy,
not
you can get them, maybe like 20
really
bucks.
Not.
And you buy candy like, what, three, four times?
Because of how many people are coming.
The last time actually counts.
Costumes are outrageous.
Are.
That's probably why, I appreciate my parents making them when I was younger because I look at these costumes now, like, what is this? And a thin piece of fabric and a piece of plastic for a mask? I can make that for way cheaper, and they're charging you, $80 sometimes for that.
Yeah.
I know, it can be very expensive.
I remember some of the costumes where they had the little elastic band.
You couldn't breathe,
always broke. And some of them they weren't even fabric. They were like a plastic. Like a plastic thing, and you tied it on the side, and you'd walk 2 feet.
Might as well wear a lobster bib.
They would rip, and they were expensive.
Well, you bring up a good point that your parents actually could make those costumes, because it's true, it saves a lot of money if you're able to DIY it, and there's always good ideas, too, in Pinterest if people are thinking, $75, that's a lot of money.
If you have felt and a glue gun, those are going to be your best friends this Halloween.
I do like the people who do go all out for Halloween. They'll decorate the yard, and some people enjoy Halloween more than they do Christmas.
Oh, yeah.
They really love it. And the old neighborhood I used to live in, they would decorate like crazy. And tomorrow there'll be a huge parade with about 400 or 500 people.
Wow. It's fun to walk up to those houses. Yep. I remember there being haunted houses, and it was just, neighborhood homes that would go all out. But I've looked at those decorations in stores, and you'll get the skeletons or the ones that pop out of the coffin, and those sometimes
they're
go up to $1,000.
Right.
No, but that's an expense in and of itself.
It's true. It's not just for the Christmas that you see everybody in their lawns. They have some sort of like haunted trail that you can go through before you go up and get your candy. There's that. There's just so many expenses nowadays that the companies are saying like, hey, you got to buy this, you got to buy that, you got to buy this. It's like, it's just ridiculous.
I just do the candy, I'll carve a pumpkin, and that's pretty much it.
Not a fan of the inflatables.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, yeah.
No. I think I'm going to pass on those.
But I find them very humorous if you do have them.
Mm-hmm.
Well, here's what some of our Facebook friends are saying. Donna Mitchell weighs in today and says, I work in retail, and we've been selling Halloween since August.
I believe it.
Yep. Almost everything is gone, so people sure are spending money on Halloween. Patricia Adelo Estrella tells us, I always buy treats for the kiddies and the young at heart, but the decorations after Halloween to use the following year. That's a good tip. We always do that in my house. Jamie Mark says, I don't spend money on Halloween candy for the kids. I buy toothbrushes and hand them out.
I don't think
kids like your house. Sorry.
I'm egging the house.
You're like the lady that gives out pencils.
Will just said he's going to egg your house. Margarita Cruz says, don't really decorate much, but enjoy giving out candy to the kiddies. All right, I'm at the New England Tech Center. Let's take a look at some other trend-worthy topics that are online today. Well, Halloween is still a day away, but hundreds of dogs celebrated fashionably early. And the 23rd annual Halloween Dog Parade in New York's East Village was nothing short of amazing. Following the tradition of years past, the park was packed with dogs and owners in unbelievably creative costumes. Pumpkin Spice Latte was definitely a crowd pleaser, as was Rapunzel's alluring look. Check this out, even though, some onlookers might have been skeptical that that was her true hair color. Well, dogs even dressed up like other animals here, and it was seriously hard to choose what my favorite was this morning, but what can I say? I'm a sucker for small dogs and the theater. This one is the winner for me. Well, with all the talk around Halloween tomorrow and Red Sox tonight, here's a video that combines the two. The San Diego State baseball team has an awesome fall tradition where every year they play an exhibition game in their Halloween costumes. Check out who's sharing the diamond this season.
I'm ready.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
I'm gonna
Well, I wouldn't say playing baseball is on with costumes is much cooler, but definitely entertaining. Well, you can find a link to more dog Halloween parade photos and the baseball and costumes video on the Rhode Show page on WPRI.com. And as always, we want to hear what you think. So leave us a comment on our Facebook page, or you can follow us on Twitter at the Rhode Show.